military weapons. The Boeing AH-64 Apache is an American four-blade twin-turboshaft attack helicopter with a tailwheel-type landing gear arrangement of a tandem cockpit for a two-man crew. It features a nose-mounted sensor suite for target acquisition and night vision systems. It is armed with 30mm M230 chain gun carried between the main landing gear under the aircraft's forward fuselage. It has four hardpoints mounted on sub-wing pylons, typically carrying a mixture of AGM-114 Hellfire missiles and Hydra 70 rocket pods. The AH-64 has a large amount of systems redundancy to improve combat survivability. The AH-64 is adaptable to numerous different roles within its context as close combat attack. In addition to the 30mm 230 E1 chain gun, the Apache carries a range of external stores and weapons on its stub-wing pylons. Typically, a mixture of AGM-114 Hellfire anti-tank missiles and Hydra 70 general-purpose unguided 70mm rockets. One 18-aircraft Apache battalion equipped with Hellfire missiles is capable of destroying 288 tanks. Since 2005, the Hellfire missile is sometimes outfitted with a thermobaric warhead. Designated AGM-114N, it is intended to use for ground forces and urban warfare operations. The use of thermobaric enhanced blast weapons, such as the AGM-114N, have been a point of controversy. In October of 2015, the United States Army ordered its first batch of advanced precision kill weapon systems guided 70mm rockets for the Apache. Boeing has suggested that the AH-64 could be fitted with a directed energy weapon. The company has developed a small laser weapon, initially designed to engage small UAVs, that uses a high-resolution telescope to direct a 210 kilowatt beam with a diameter of a penny out to a range of 5.4 nmi. On the Apache, the laser could be used to destroy enemy communications or radio equipment. On the 14th of July 2016, it was reported that the AH-64 had successfully completed testing of MBDA Brimstone anti-armor missiles. U.S. Apache served in Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan from 2001. U.S. Apache served in Operation Enduring Freedom in Afghanistan from 2001. U.S. AH-64Ds typically flew in Afghanistan and Iraq without the longbow radar in the absence of armored threats. On December 21, 2009, a pair of Apaches attacked a British-held base in a friendly fire incident, killing one British soldier. In 2006, Thomas Adams noted that Apaches often fought in small teams with little autonomy to react to threats and opportunities, requiring lengthy dialogue with command structures in an effort to centrally micromanage each unit. AH-64D Apache flying over Baghdad, Iraq in 2007 on a reconnaissance mission. In 2003, the AH-64 participated in the invasion of Iraq during Operation Iraqi Freedom. On the 24th of March 2003, 31 Apaches were damaged and one shot down and captured in an unsuccessful attack on Iraqi Republican Guard Armored Brigade near Kabbalah. Iraqi tank crews had set up a farmer with a Brno rifle shot down the Apache, but the farmer denied involvement. The helicopter came down intact, and both the pilot and co-pilot were captured. The AH-64D was destroyed via airstrike the following day. By the end of U.S. military operations in Iraq, in December of 2011, several Apache helicopters had been shot down by enemy fire, and others lost in accidents. In 2006, an Apache was downed by a Soviet-made Strela 2 in Iraq, despite the Apache being typically able to avoid such missiles. In 2007, four Apache helicopters were destroyed on the ground by insurgent mortar fire using web-published geotagged photographs taken by soldiers. Several AH-64s were lost to accidents in Afghanistan as of 2012. Most Apaches that took heavy damage were able to continue their missions and return safely. If you like this video, leave a comment below, and thanks for watching.